In this tutorial, what we're going to do is map this many-to-many relationship between the supplier and the customer using entity framework, then insert and select the data. Okay, let's create a new application. And choose do not go web application, and we have web application as well. Now it will restore the packages. Yes, it's completed. We need to add some packages before we start. Let's add those things, and always make sure to choose a compatible version, otherwise it will not work. Your package versions can be different, and please make sure to select the correct one for your project. I will put the link to the repository of this code so you can refer it. Okay, let's add the connection string to the app settings file. You can generate the connection string like this. I'm gonna use the test2 database in here. This is the connection string that you want to connect to the database. Type connection string, and then curly braces. Now the connection name, and then the value. Let's add our application dbcontext class, and we're going to add it as a service so we can use it in the dependency injection, and I will show you how to do it, and so just follow the video. In the configure service method, we're going to add our application dbcontext class. So type application dbcontext ethics, and we need to pass the DB context options. It must be available right now, so just hold it and press control and the dot on the period, and import this package It will take some time to restore the packages. In here, we're going to get our connection history from the JSON file, settings JSON file. Type it like this, and yeah, that's it. Okay, let's do a rebuild and check whether there is any errors. Okay, it built without any errors. So let's start adding our database models. If we manually map the customer and the supplier relationship, we need to create another table to store the customer's primary key and the supplier's primary key. So like that, we need to create another class to show that relationship between these two classes. So I'm going to create customer supplier class, and I'm going to add some attributes, and I will explain them later. For this class, we need four member variables, and two will be customer's ID and the supplier's ID, which are the primary keys of the supplier class and the customer class. And these two will be mapped by the entity framework, and we don't need to worry about that. So then we need to add another two member variables to hold the customer's object and the supplier's object. And when we create object from this class, we only need custom object or supply object, and it depends on the situation, and I will show you how to do this later. So we need to add a list type of customer supplier, because one customer can have many suppliers. Now we need to create the mentor-mentee relationship with navigation, and we need to override the method on model creating. In here we tell that these are the keys of custom supply table, which are custom ID and supply ID. In here we tell that customer suppliers, one customer can have many suppliers. This supply member variable is a list of customer supply object that we define in the customer class. And then we tell the what is the foreign key for this. It should be customer ID. Okay, let's do the same for the supply as well. For one supplier, there can be many customers. This customer is the member variable of suppliers, as you can see. And customers, and we tell what is the foreign key for this, which is going to be the supply ID. Okay, let's add the migration. Click on the package manage console and type add migration and type the name. Okay, this looks like we are missing a package. Let's install it using the package manager. Just copy the name and open the package manager. Okay, let's install it. Please make sure to select the correct version. The my version will be different from yours. So select the correct version. Okay, let's do it again. Okay, migration is added and we need to update our database. As you can see, now the tables have been created. Let's create a database diagram and check whether the relations, the main-to-main relation is mapped correctly. As you can see, it's mapped correctly, and let's implement an API to check to perform the data inserting and the selecting.